Yeah. So, good morning, all of you. So, in last class, we confirmed that structure of the glucose and fructose. Okay. So that is a cyclic structure of the glucose and fructose. Okay. So now here, today let us discuss the cyclic structure of the glucose. Why we need to discuss the cyclic structure of the glucose? Because that is present in cyclic structure. That is present in cyclic structure. So how to find out that is present in a cyclic structure? Based on some failures. Okay. So what are those failures? The glucose on reaction with sodium bisulfite, no reaction. On reaction sodium bisulfite, no reaction. So generally, if aldehyde group is present, that must react with sodium bisulfite. Okay. Here Na plus HSO4, HSO3 minus. So here OH, for suppose ONAH, SO3H. Okay, it is addition product. Bisulfide, the product is a white crystalline compound. White crystalline compound, insoluble in water. We can separate this one. Okay, of course this is a reversible reaction. Okay, this is a reversible reaction. By dilution, again it is converted to diol. Okay, this diol unstable, so it is converted to carbonyl compound by loss of water. So if there is a presence of the aldehyde group, that must react with the sodium bisulfite. Of course, that aldehyde group reacted with HCN, reacted with hydroxyl amine. Okay, close the mask because I am not wearing mask, so you should wear the mask. Okay, and that will be okay. This one, so this one reactor, this glucose reacted with HCN hydroxyl amine. That indicates presence of the aldehyde group. In fructose, presence of the keto group. So actually here, this hydroxyl amine and HCN, these reagents are more reactive towards aldehyde and ketone. These reagents are the more reactive, but sodium bisulfate is the less reactive. And that glucose fructose reacted with Pehling solution as well as Tollens reagent. Now here, this one on reaction with Sif's reagent. Okay, Sif's reagent. No reaction. Between Tollens to Pehling, which is more reactive? Tollens is a more reactive. Pehling is a less reactive. That's why that Pehling solution cannot oxidize aromatic aldehydes. Is it? Aromatic aldehydes do not react with Pehling solution. Even though aliphatic aldehydes react with Pehling solution. Because aliphatic aldehydes are more reactive in addition reaction, that means nucleophilic addition reactions, whatever it is. So because of the aromatic, that pi conjugation, here magnitude of the positive charge decreases. So aromatic aldehydes are less reactive. Aliphatic aldehydes are more reactive. So less reactive aldehyde is not reacted with Pehling solution. Pehling solutions are weak. Than the Pehling solution, Sif's reagent is a very weaker. Glucose can react with more reactive Tollens and more reactive Pehling, that means somewhat more reactive than the Sif's reagent. The Sif's reagent is a very less reactive. What is the Sif's reagent? Para rosanilin hydrochloride. The structure jipthum. That contains three benzene rings. Okay. There are NH2 groups. Para rosanilin hydrochloride. There is a pink in color. If that compound is passing through the SO2 gas, that is decolorized. Again, that is passed through the aldehyde. That pink color is restored. That's if test on it. It is a very weak. It is a reacted with only more reactive carbonic compounds, means aldehydes. Okay. So here, this, even though glucose contains aldehyde group, but no reaction. Okay. That is one point. Okay. That is one observation. That means here, from this point, we can understand that aldehyde group is not present in a free position. The aldehyde group is not present freely in the glucose. Okay. For suppose here glucose CHOCHOH 4 times CH2OH. This one on reaction with the acetic anhydride in acid medium. What is the product here? Double bond OH. CHOAC 4 times SCH2OS. Okay, this one pentaacetyl derivative is a pentaacetyl derivative. Okay, if it is exactly real structure, this is the pentaacetyl derivative. If it is exactly product, this one must react with which one? Hydroxyamine, because there is a presence of the aldehyde group. Okay, but no reaction. If there is a presence of the aldehyde group, that must react with HCN, but no reaction. Here penta OH-acetyl derivative. Here it can react with HCN or a hydroxylamine or a Torrance reagent. Now with Torrance reagent, okay, Torrance reagent no reaction, and sodium bisulfite also no reaction. But here acyclic structure of this one can react with. Simple glucose. Okay, it's not a pentaacetyl derivative. That can react with the hydroxylamine, react with the HCN, react with the Torrance. Okay, there also no reaction with the Fehling solution. Okay, this one can react with the Fehling solution. There is a reaction. That means here, from this point, this aldehyde group is not present freely in a glucose. Okay. That is present in a other form. That is present in a different form. Or suppose this aldehyde on reaction with alcohol, here RO minus H plus, H plus combines with O minus, RO minus combines with C plus, that means RC OH, your hydrogen OR. It is actually hemiacetal. Okay. This hemiacetal, on reaction with Torrance reagent, there is a positive reaction. Fehling reagent, there is a positive reaction. Okay. There actually here you can see there is no aldehyde group, but there is a positive reaction with Torrance reagent as well as Fehling solution. Why? Because it is a basic medium. Alkaline solution. This alkali solution OH minus remove the H plus. So here RO minus H and O. Reformation of pi bond, leaving of this alkoxide group. So double bond OH plus RO. Now this aldehyde group can react with Torrance and Fehling. That is actually taking place in this reaction. That means here, this even this aldehyde group is present in a hemiacetal form that can react with the Torrance reagent as well as Fehling reagent. Can react with Torrance as well as Fehling. Okay. Because of the alkali solution, that is open, that is converted to the aldehyde form. Now aldehyde form can aldehyde can react with Torrance as well as Fehling. Okay. So here from this point, here glucose is present in a some cyclic structure that is not present in a that is aldehyde group is not freely present. So that glucose, okay, that aldehyde group form a cyclic hemiacetal with OH which is present at the fifth carbon. Okay, that means here 1 2 3 4 5 6, you get the six membered cyclic hemiacetal. If aldehyde react with one mole of the alcohol, hemiacetal. Okay, one mole of the alcohol, hemiacetal. Or suppose furtherly, the second mole of the alcohol, loss of water molecule. So here OH, this is acetal. That is acetal. Hemiacetal, ester. But in this case here, this OH which is present at the fifth carbon form a cyclic hemiacetal with the aldehyde group. That means that aldehyde group is not freely present. That is present in a cyclic hemiacetal structure. Now by reacting with tolerance and failing, that cyclic hemiacetal is open to the acyclic structure. And then in acyclic structure, there is a free CHO group that can react with tolerance and failing. We will get the positive result. Okay, that's it. So then what is the cyclic structure? Let us discuss. Okay, so write down. Okay, first write down this one. Okay, after discussion of the cyclic structure, we can understand why this one cannot give these reactions. Okay, I will discuss again. From above observations, we can understand that aldehyde group in glucose is not present freely. That form a cyclic hemiacetal ring. That form a cyclic hemiacetal with OH of fifth carbon. Okay. Here, when that aldehyde group converted into hemiacetal, one new chiral carbon is generated. Initially it's not a chiral carbon, sp2, it's not a chiral carbon. After reaction becomes sp3, it's a chiral carbon. Chiral carbon may be R configuration or S configuration. We'll get the two. That means here this aldehyde molecule when involved in a cyclic hemiacetal formation, we'll get the another one chiral carbon. About that chiral carbon, we have a different configuration. Okay, write the one point. As a result of the cyclic hemiacetal formation, aldehyde carbon becomes chiral, aldehyde carbon becomes chiral. This newly generated chiral carbon is known as anomeric carbon. This newly generated carbon, chiral carbon, is known as anomeric carbon. Other than anomeric carbon, epimeric carbons. First carbon is anomeric carbon here in this case. Other carbons, for example, glucose monose C2 epimers, glucose galactose C4 epimers. Okay. Newly generated chiral carbon is known as anomeric carbon. Then we have two types of cyclic structures. known as anomers. Okay, see this. Now it is a glucose, a cyclic structure of the glucose. It form a cyclic structure with the fifth carbon.
First one, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one. Okay.
చెప్పు కాలేజీలో ఉన్నాను అర్జెంటా. ఓకే, సిక్స్ కార్బన్. ఓకే, నౌ హియర్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద కాన్ఫిగరేషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ కైరల్ కార్బన్, బాటమ్ మోస్ట్ కైరల్ కార్బన్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్. యార్ ఓహెచ్ ఫస్ట్ ప్రయారిటీ. Okay, OH first right. Now here, this carbon has OH, this carbon has a OH. Okay, but this carbon has two hydrogens. This carbon has one hydrogen, one more carbon. So here, this one has a second right. This one third right. So 1, 2, 3, anti-clockwise, S configuration, but you have to take the reverse R. Okay, now here, this one, I am changing like this. Double of bond O, hydrogen. Here OH, hydrogen. This OH, hydrogen. H, okay. Here in this case, just rotate the, that means exchange of groups. The CH2OH goes to this position. That means here OH and CH2. This hydrogen comes to this position. This OH comes to this position. Now check the configuration. First priority, second priority. Okay, this is third priority. So 1, 2, 3, anti-clockwise, yes sir, but take the reverse R. Same configuration. By rotating that, configuration is not changed. So both are the same. Okay, for our convenience actually. That is rotated like this. Now here, this fifth carbon, this is the OH on the fifth carbon. Form a cyclic hemiester. Now it becomes a chiral. Kaushik Reddy. Becomes a chiral. So here, this chiral carbon, OH on the right side, hydrogen on the left side. Okay, next, this one. OH, H. This cyclic structure getting some confusion. Okay, here, listen this carefully. This OH, CH2, hydrogen. This is oxygen. So here cyclic structure oxygen like this. No carbons here. No carbons. Okay. So here in this case, first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, sixth carbon. Okay. Na? And here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is a six-membered ring actually. Okay, that is a six-membered. Now this is the one possible isomer. Now OH may be on the left side hydrogen. So again here hydrogen, this OH, this one H, this one OH. Hydrogen, this OH, hydrogen. OCH2. Okay, again this one. Okay, these two are the possible isomers. These two are the dashed isomers. Because these are the non-mirror images. A different configuration at only first carbon. Same configuration at other carbons. Okay. Same configuration. So actually here, this is the alpha enomer, this is the beta enomer. These two are the enomers each other. Okay. The pair of diastereomers which differ configuration at the anomeric carbon, newly generated carbon. Those are the enomers. Okay. A pair of diastereomers which have a different configuration other than anomeric carbon. Those are the epimers. Okay. Of course, this enomers term is mostly applicable to the cyclic structures. Epimers are the acyclic. Glucose, fructose, glucose and mannose, glucose and galactose. Here, this is alpha D plus, alpha D plus, because dextrorotatory. Alpha D plus. Glucopyranose. Okay, now here it is a beta D plus glucopyranose. Okay, why it is called as a pyranose? Because you will get the six membered ring. I am writing the six membered ring with oxygen like this. With oxygen, six membered ring. Now here it is the first carbon, second carbon, this third carbon, fourth carbon, this is the fifth carbon. Okay. Again for this one also. Oxygen. Okay. Now here, the grooves which are present on the right side. Okay. Grooves which are present on the right side. We should write bottom. Okay. Downward right. Right side groups comes to the downward. That means here OH right side. Huh? So here OH downward. That hydrogen left. Here OH right side. So that comes to the downward remaining hydrogen. Now this hydrogen downward, OH upward. This hydrogen. OH down, here OH downward, here OH downward, here hydrogen, this one OH. OH this one. Now here hydrogen downward, this CH2OH upward. Okay, that is the structure. Actually here, this six membered ring with oxygen. Okay, with the double bond is pyrene. Actually pyrene. That's why it is called as a pyranose. Glucose. Okay, that's why pyranose. It is alpha isomer. Alpha D plus glucopyranose. Okay, here in this case, OH upward, this hydrogen downward. The grooves which are on the right side, you must write the downward. Okay, hydrogen downward, this OH downward, this hydrogen downward, remaining same, OH hydrogen. this hydrogen downward and it is a CH2. Okay, so actually here this carbon is anomeric carbon. This is anomeric carbon. Newly generated carbon is anomeric carbon. Okay, na? That's it. So generally here, these are the power projection formulas. Okay, these are the Haworth projection formula or Haworth formula. Scientist, actually that scientist identified the cyclic structure. Haworth projection formula. Okay, now it is a six-membered ring. So six-membered ring is present in a chiral form. Six-membered ring is present in chiral form. So here, then write the chiral form for this one. Oxygen, this one. Okay, now here this is axial. Okay, na? This is equatorial. This is axial. This is equatorial. This is axial. Okay, na? From starting carbon, axial, equatorial, axial, equatorial. All downward carbon, all downward groups. The bottom one groups are called alternative rasta. Axial, equatorial, axial, equatorial, axial. That means here OH axial means here this is the first carbon. Oxygen, it is the first carbon. OH axial means here, this is the axial position. This is equatorial position. It means hydrogen equatorial. If it is axial, hydrogen is equatorial. Okay, you understand? Here in this case, OH equatorial. Equatorial means here, this one. Straight one of them, this is the axial. Now, at third carbon, axial, OH, equatorial. That's it. Next, at fourth carbon, OH equatorial. This is the equatorial position. This is the axial position. Now at fifth carbon, axial equatorial. This is the axial. Axial means here downward. Here CH2OH. Equatorial. This is the equatorial. That is cyclic structure. That means chiral form. Bubble. They are getting ants. Huh? This oxygen. So here, axial, equatorial. Axial, equatorial. Axial. This is axial means here, this OH. Equatorial. This is the equatorial position. Now remaining all are same. So OH, OH, this OH, this one, OH. Alpha isomer, beta isomer. So generally, between these two, which is more stable? Alpha and beta. When group is present in equatorial position, that is the more stable. This hydrogen OH, which is smaller hydrogen. Larger group must present in equatorial position. So this is the more stable. This is more stable. Beta form, beta anomer is the more stable than the alpha anomer. Alpha. OH axial position, alpha. OH downward, alpha. OH right side, alpha. Here OH left side, beta. OH upward, beta. OH equatorial, beta. Okay? That's it. Okay? The anomeric carbon. These are the diastereomers. These two are the diastereomers because non-mirror images have different configuration at only one carbon. Okay. Note, anomers are the diastereomers. Okay, right. Bainadi. Okay, so pyrene. These are the Fischer projections. These are Fischer projection. Fischer projection is nothing but 2D representation of the 3D molecule. It is a 3D representation. Okay. Here, Haworth formula. with the representation of vertical line and horizontal line, the Fisher projection. Okay, so glucose present in a cyclic structure. One is alpha isomer, other one is beta isomer. These two are the anomers. Beta anomer is more stable than the alpha anomer. Okay, now okay, see the structure. This one OH. Okay, I'm taking one isomer. Okay, taking one isomer. This one CH2OH, OH, this one OH. Okay, beta isomer. Let us take the one isomer beta. Here in this case, this one on reaction with the, okay, this one on reaction with the H2 nickel, on reaction with the red phosphorus and HI. What is the product? N-hexane is the product. Okay, N-hexane is the product. This one on reaction with the hydroxyl amide. There is a reaction possible. Actually, there is an aldehyde group, but here, due to effectiveness of these reagents, red phosphorus HA or H2NOH, hydroxyl amine, due to effectiveness of this reagent, here it is converted to this complete aldehyde form. That means here O minus, okay, double up bond O plus hydrogen. Okay, this is the OH, this is OH, this one is the OH. Now proton is transferred to this oxygen. Okay, proton is transferred to that oxygen. So it is nothing but, which one it is? Acyclic structure of glucose. Now it can react actually. Hemiasters are unstable. Hemiasters are the unstable because that carbon attached to the two more electronegative groups. Okay, then a loss of alcohol takes place, that is converted to carbonyl group. Okay, so that's why here the cyclic hemiester is opened by the effectiveness of the reagent hydroxyl amine or HCN or tollens reagent or bromine water or HNO3 or pairing reagent. Open, complete reaction. But here, this cyclic structure, that means this glucose does not react with sodium bisulfate. It's a less effective reagent. Okay, that's why this cyclic hemiester is not open. Okay. And next, Schiff's reagent, no reaction. That's it. Now, why penta acetyl derivative of the glucose, even no reaction with the tollens reagent? Now here, see this. What is the penta acetyl derivative of the glucose? What is the penta acetyl derivative of the glucose? See this one. Acetic anhydride, 5 moles of the acetic anhydride. Okay? This glucose, okay, you see this one, penta-O-acetyl derivative. Here it becomes a OAC. Now it becomes a OAC. It becomes a OAC. It becomes a OAC. Now it becomes a OAC. How many moles of acetic anhydride consumed? 5 moles. Now in this penta-O-acetyl derivative, there is no free OH group. There is no free OH group. Okay, if there is a free OH group, that can reduce the tollens reagent and Pehling reagent. Okay, so actually here, this one on reaction with the tollens reagent, no reaction. On reaction with the Pehling reagent, no reaction. Okay, or on reaction with the hydroxyl amine, no reaction. Okay, so because it is a stable pentavalent derivative of the glucose is a stable. If there is a OH at this position, it is open to the acyclic structure. There is no OH. There is no OH group here. It is C double bond O CH stabilized by the resonance. So in this case, because of the resonance, this oxygen becomes a partial positive. Partially positive. That gains positive charge. That means here it's not a that means more electronegative. It's not a more electronegative. So it means here if carbon contains two more electronegative groups, okay, easily loss of alcohol, or if contains two OH groups, so loss of water molecule. Okay, that's it. So here inko point endandi inko vera cheppochu, this one cannot reduce the Torrance and Pehling, because Torrance and Pehling solutions have alkaline nature, have alkaline nature. If there is a alkali, if there is a alkali medium, here OH minus remove the H plus, remove the H plus, that becomes a O minus. This O minus form a pi bond, and breaking of this ring, that means O minus, this is double bond. That is the aldehyde group. Aldehyde group can give the positive Torrance and Pehling. That's why penta oester derivative does not react with Torrance reagent as well as Pehling reagent, because there is no free OH group. At anomeric carbon, if there is a free OH group, that can be the, that can reduce the Torrance and Pehling. That's why here we can give the one statement. Reducing sugars have pre-OH group. Reducing sugars have pre-OH group at the anomeric carbon. There is a pre-OH group at the anomeric carbon. Okay, nah? It can reduce the Pehling and Torrance. Because that OH is converted to O- in alkali medium. That is converted to aldehyde group. So that can reduce the Torrance and Pehling. Or suppose oxygen, here OCH3, this is OH, this is OH, this is OH, this is OH. Now this one Torrance reagent, Pehling reagent, no reaction, no reaction, because there is no free OH group, there is no H plus. Okay, now suppose I am taking like this, here OH, this is OCH3, this is OCH3, this is OCH3, this one is the OCH3 or OSC, whatever it is. Now it can reduce or not? Yes, it can reduce, because there is a free OH group, free OH group, that is converted to O minus, O minus to aldehyde group. That can reduce. So finally here I am giving the one statement. If there is a free OH group at the anomeric carbon, that can reduce the Torrance and Pehling. Then that is known as a reducing sugar. So reducing sugars have the free OH group at the anomeric carbon. If there is no OH group at the anomeric carbon, that is a non-reducing sugar. So that's why sucrose is a non-reducing. There two anomeric carbons are combined. We'll discuss. But maltose, reducing sugar. Maltose is the combination of the two glucose units. In that case, one glucose unit has a free OH group. That's why it can reduce. Okay, we'll discuss. So that's it. That's why pentavalent derivative cannot reduce the Torrance, Pehling, no reaction with hydroxyl. Okay, that's it. So finally, one statement. Reducing sugars have free OH group at anomeric carbon, anomeric carbon, and non-reducing sugars, non-reducing sugars have not free OH group at anomeric carbon. Okay, at anomeric. That's it. Madam.